Facebook is not cooperating this morning. Let's see if YouTube does a little better. And then we will get started. Well, I believe that we're live on YouTube now. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. This is a day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to Witherspoon Street Presbyterian Church morning prayer. We will push past and through live on YouTube now. Any of our difficulties. I'm hearing some feedback. This is a day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome. I don't know what I need to do in order to resolve this.
Exit the YouTube browser.
We'll push past. All right.
Yeah.
I'm getting some instruction here about. Resolved it. Okay. So let's try again. Good thing about YouTube is that you can edit it later, so we'll be able to edit this video. But for those of us who are live, you see how it works live and in person. And again, I greet you. I say to you, good morning. Welcome to our morning prayer. We gather together every morning, Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. for prayer. Very simply, we know that prayer is important. We know that prayer is powerful. We know that prayer is transformational, that prayer changes us as much as it changes situation. We don't use prayer as simply a ritual to engage in, but we know that we draw something out of it. And we want to create the opportunity for others to join us in that. I think that every day that we pray, we discover more and more the power of prayer. We discover what prayer can do and how it is so functional. It allows us to start our day differently when we begin with prayer, when we commit ourselves to come together as sisters and brothers in prayer. And so we have been doing this going back since just after Easter when we began. And we normally give testimonies on Wednesdays, and so I'll not share a lot of it now, but I will say this, that we have come to understand that prayer is changing us individually. Prayer is changing what's happening with our families. Prayer is changing what's happening with our church, and we believe that prayer can change you. I want to start this morning. I was reading. I don't have the book with me. I do a daily devotional with the poet Rumi, the Sufi poet Rumi. Some of you may be familiar with Rumi. And he talked today about being tired of his words, that the thing that he waves around, the flag. He just wants the flag holder now. Like Khalil Gibran said it another way. He said that when we cease to be at peace with our thoughts, that we live in our lips, and in talking, thinking is often half murdered. And I want to start really as a Thanksgiving for last night. As you all know, I frequently do not look forward to our session meetings. But yesterday the Spirit said, you know, fill your day with laughter, fill your day with peace, with joy. Let that be your preparation. And so I did that all day and only spent the last hour right before the session meeting actually doing the business preparation work of reading documents. And it really, I think, affected the mood. And so in Thanksgiving, what I'd like to do is I want to start with the way that I started last night at the session meeting. I want to share a couple of things with you here. First, some of you may not be familiar with the phenomenal ancestor and jazz artist John Coltrane. John Coltrane was canonized as a saint. Saint John Will.i.am Coltrane in the African Orthodox Church. The African Orthodox Church is a church that was started back during the time of Marcus Mosiah Garvey, along with Bishop McGuire, who was an Episcopal priest. But the African Orthodox Church was created as an expression of connecting African people more closely to their God as they were being connected to the continent and to one another. Last night I played a psalm from John Coltrane, from his Love Supreme album. You may be familiar with that, but he had a number of songs that were called Love Supreme. This is Love Supreme number 4. I am going to try to share it with you. Let's see if I can. I want to pause it here. It's not pausing. I want to make sure the sound goes right, because I don't want it to be garbled. So this is Love Supreme number 4, and it's called Psalm. So let's begin just in our prayers, just thoughtfully giving thanksgiving and focusing on whatever it is that God needs to say to us as we prepare to pray together, what God needs to say to us individually. Let's listen to Love Supreme, number 4, Psalm. Thank you. Amen. 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 So that was A Love Supreme.
Amen.
Number 4, Psalm. I know that at least maybe a couple of us heard that last night, but I wanted to hear it again this morning. And I would encourage you, if you want to go back yourself and listen to it again. It's one thing to listen to it with the words that John Coltrane put together. And then that's one way of hearing it. But then it's something else when you just allow God to speak to you, allow the Spirit to speak to you through the music. because I got and I get a completely, not a completely different, but a very individual message that often is translated and transmitted to me through music such as this. Some of you may not know that John Coltrane, he wrote a letter to his first wife, Naima. And as he was going through this process of transformation in his music, he said, at this point, 90% of all the music that I'm doing is prayer. All of it, 90% of it is prayer. And you have to follow John Coltrane in terms of his trajectory and his spiritual depth. I mean, he grew up in the church, son of a preacher, grandson of a preacher, but he really began to grow and to expand and be transformed in his self and in his art and in his ministry as he moved forward in life. I mean, he was able to, through his music, deal with alcoholism and drug abuse and really just a phenomenal life lived. If you haven't had the opportunity to spend some time, there are a lot of resources out there. Let me tell you what the Spirit has said to me this morning and listening to Coltrane and some of the messaging in my early morning prayers. There's a passage of scripture in the book of Ephesians that talks about putting on the full armor of God. And there the writer uses the metaphor and the imagery of a soldier who is puts on a helmet of salvation, carries a shield of faith, a breastplate of righteousness, a belt of truth, boots of the gospel, carries the sword of the word, and uses the image of a soldier as a way to communicate the need for us to be spiritually dressed and equipped and armed in order to face the battle, and it says so that you will be able to withstand the flaming arrows of the enemy. And one of the reflections that I've had about this passage of scripture and the use of the imagery of the soldier is that in isolation, it's insufficient. That if you simply have on your helmet and your breastplate and your shield and your belt and your boots and you're carrying your sword and you're facing an enemy that is firing flaming arrows, all of the equipment that you have on is only especially useful if the flaming arrows are coming from the front. If the enemy is shooting a flaming arrow from behind you, you're really limited in your ability to confront that enemy. I remember watching some of these movies like Braveheart. I don't know if you've ever seen that. And then there's a scene when the other army that's lined up across from them are shooting arrows at them, and at one point they all just put up their shields and they fall back, but then every now and then there's an arrow that comes down and hits somebody in the leg, because the shield can only cover but so much, and it's even only a useful defensive strategy because the two lines are facing one another face to face, and that's how they're confronting one another. But when the enemy attacks differently from behind, and that's how the enemy frequently does it. While you're celebrating, you need some other people with you who have your back. You need a squad. I also have been reading that scripture, knowing that if we just treat it in isolation, it can be insufficient, because sometimes when the flaming arrow is fired at us and we have our shield of faith, we're fully dressed, it can bounce off of the shield and it can hit somebody who's next to you. You might duck and it may hit someone behind you. You may be fully dressed and have on what you need to wear, but your squad, your circle, is vulnerable. And sometimes the ones who catch the arrows that miss us are our family members. Sometimes it's our children, our loved ones. But this morning, what the Spirit said to me is, pray for your circle. Pray for your squad. Because if the enemy can't get at you, the enemy just goes for whoever's around you. And I know you all have heard me say that. I know that the enemy sometimes comes for your children. So I'm not even talking about children this morning. I'm talking about wanting you to think about who's in your circle. Who is a part of your prayer squad? Who do you have to call when the flaming arrows of the enemy are raining down upon you? Is your squad dressed? Do they have on their helmet and their belt and their shield and their breastplate and their boots? Do they have their sword ready? Do you have a squad? Who do you have to pray with? You know, some of us recognize the value that when we, based on what we've gone through in life or the kind of business that we conduct, that, you know, you need to have a lawyer on retainer. You know, I was having this conversation with a member of our church. I said, I appreciate the fact that we may have lawyers who are members of the church, but our church needs to have a lawyer on retainer that whenever something happens, they work for us. And we can call them up and we can ask them to review a document, or we can ask them to respond to a document or whatever else. Someone who is dedicated and committed to be there for us in a particular way. We know that when we go to the doctor, who's your primary care provider? You know, there's somebody who already has your charts, somebody who already knows what you've been through, who already has a sense of your medical history and who you trust and who you know and who you know knows your body, that is who you go to when you have a crisis, when you have something that's happening. You know, when it's tax time, when it's time to deal things with the money, you have an accountant or tax preparer or someone who you know and who you trust who you go to, because you know you can't do everything. You may be smart, but there are people who also have gifts and talents that help you to do. You know, you do your part. You get together all your records. You kept your receipts. You have your W-2s, and you know what things that you're going to do, and you're going to review what it is that they prepare, but you trust them that they are a part of your circle. Do you have a prayer circle? Do you have a spiritual circle? Do you have those who are there for you and with you in times of prayer? Because I tell you that we have, and we will continue to have, flaming arrows that come from the enemy, and those arrows will come from the front. And maybe if you're dressed, you'll be able to protect yourself, but they'll also come from the back. And you need to make sure that those who are next to you, not just for you to know that you have them, but are they taken care of? Because you need them. You need your lawyer and your doctor and your accountant to be okay. I remember before Truth Surgery praying for the doctor. I needed him to have a good weekend for that Monday morning surgery. I needed him not to go out and get drunk that weekend and be hung over in surgery early the next morning. I needed for everybody to treat him right and for him not to be mad and for him to be in good relationship with the people in his family and in his community when he was preparing to do surgery on my son. You need your people to be well, to be dressed, to be equipped. We need to pray for our circles. Some of us may need to be praying that that God will send us people to fill out our circle, because by ourselves, even if we have on shield and helmet and breastplate and belt and boots and sword, they're inadequate in isolation to deal with the kind of attacks that we will receive from the enemy. But if you do have someone or two, if you do have a squad, if you do have a prayer partner, if you do have a prayer ally, if you do have a prayer warrior, if you do have someone who will pray with you and for you and about you, and who you know that in the morning that they are going to war for you and on your behalf, pray for them. Because if you're doing okay and the enemy cannot get at you, then the enemy will go for your circle. Because the enemy knows that you need your squad, that you need your circle, that you need those who are connected to you. So I want you to think about, who has my back? And we're going to pray for them. We're going to pray that they be protected. If they're hurt, you're hurt. If they're vulnerable, you're vulnerable. If they're injured, you're injured. So we're going to pray for those who are a part of our squad, a part of our circles, because the enemy will go after them, especially when you know you're doing well. If you're not feeling the frontal attack, know that those around you likely are. So everyone, think about who you have. Also think about who you don't have.
Yeah.
Do you need to fill out your squad? I'll tell you, I know that I do. I have some people. I got some people. I know some people. And those people know they're my people. People who I can call upon, people who will pray for me, people who will pray with you. But when you are in crisis and you're looking around trying to see where the Christ is, who are the intercessors and prayer partners that you can go to, that you can call upon, that will be there for you? If you don't have one, get one. Pray for that. Lord, send me some people. Send me a person. Send me a partner. Some of us may have had someone who used to be, and that person is now, maybe they've transitioned. Maybe you've fallen out of relationship with them. Some of us may have never had one, but we need to pray for our circle, our squad, so that we can truly resist the flaming arrows of the enemy. And also, notice, with the exception of the sword, all of the equipment is defensive. You need some people who will ride for you. You know, say a ride or die partner. Then when you just need to sit back and lay back, then they'll go and get your enemy. Say, do not touch God's anointed. Do not mess with her. Do not seek to come for her, because if you come for her, then you come for me. Let's pray for our circles. Dear Lord, thank you. Thank you for speaking to us through your servant, through his art. Thank you for communicating to us of a love supreme. Thank you for your word and your words, prepared and individually customized. Thank you. Lord God, this morning we pray for our squad. We pray for our circle. We pray for those with whom we are connected, those who pray for us, those who pray with us, those who love us, those who will ride for us, those who will have our back, our side, our front. We pray for our partners. Dear Lord, shield them. Dress them. Build them up. Encourage them. Root them. Ground them. Remind them that we are connected, that I am because we are, that we are because I am, that you have not sent us out as sheep amidst the wolves by ourselves, but that you have sent us out in pairs. You have sent us out with partners. You have sent us out with squads. You have sent us out with a team. Protect our team today. Protect those who pray for us. Keep them strong. Heal them of their wounds. Be that balm in Gilead. Be that salve. Be that medication. Be that ointment that they need for that hit that they took, whether it be on our behalf or in defense of their own integrity, dear Lord. Give them some peace. Give them some solace. Give them some comfort. Give them some healing. Give them some rest, dear Lord, and give them what they need through me, dear Lord. Help me to see what it is that they are in need of. Let me be an encourager of my squad. Let me be a supporter of those who support me. Let me not be self-centered and simply seeing them as a resource for my own benefit, as a commodity for my own use, dear Lord. Let me see that we are connected one to the other, and I care and love for them, and help me to know how to show that, how to listen to them, not just have them hear what it is that I have to say, how to pay attention to their needs and tend to their needs, dear Lord. Lord, we pray for our squad. We pray for our circle. We pray for our partners. Dear Lord, some of us are saying, oh, wow, I'm realizing how I don't have what I need as we pray this prayer. I'm realizing I'm squadless. I'm realizing that I'm without a partner. I'm thinking that I'm all alone. Lord, remind them of what you said to Elijah when Elijah thought that he was the only one. That as he faced the threats and the promises of death and destruction that came from Queen Jezebel, that she was going to kill him, how he thought he was all alone, how he thought that he was the only one who was out there fighting, how he thought that he was in battle by himself. And God said to him, no. You think you're without a squad. You think you don't have anybody. But there are 7,000 that I have kept. There are 7,000 who have not kissed the hand of the enemy. And for those who are praying this morning and thinking that they are without a circle, that they are incomplete, they are without a squad, dear Lord, send some of the 7,000. Connect them with some of those 7,000. Let them know right now that they're there. Let them know that right now that you've already been preparing them. You've already been keeping them. They're already out there. There are those who are their partners, their allies, their comrades, their community. But connect us. Connect us with our circle within the 7,000. Connect us with those who will become our prayer partners. Give us eyes to see them, dear Lord. We look out for so many other things that we want to retain. We look out for the right lawyer. We look out for the right doctor. We look out for the right financial advisor, dear Lord. Give us eyes to see the right prayer partner, the right squad member. Let us find that dating site, dear Lord, where we can be matched up with the right prayer partner, the person or persons that will pray with us and for us, dear Lord. And these are not necessarily persons who are perfect, who are complete, who have it all going on, dear Lord, but it might be the right puzzle piece that puts together the picture that fills in our gap, that allows us to be more fully revealed, dear Lord. We are all perfect in our imperfections, and it may be that we need that missing puzzle piece that allows us to see what it is that we need to see, dear Lord, and we make one another better. When they connect to me, they become. When I connect to them, I am revealed. Send us our squad members. Give us eyes to see and minds to understand and hearts to receive and spirits to discern our prayer partners, dear Lord, our squad. Dear Lord, we know that you are able. And on this day, dear Lord, we pray for those who you have sent to make us even more able. Those that you have sent to us as allies and as partners. Those that you have sent to us to stand with us and to have our front, our back, our side. Those who you have commissioned as our ride or die partners. We pray for them this morning. We pray for their strength. We pray for their encouragement. We pray for their power. We pray for their healing. We pray for their presence. We pray that they see us as we see them. We pray that you put us together with those that will allow us to not only survive, but to thrive in the face of all that is surrounding us. Hear our prayer, O Lord. Hear our prayer. Incline your ear to us and grant your peace. In the name of the one who came down so that we might go up, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, our Liberator, our Champion, our Redeemer, our Help in times of trouble, in the name of our Lord, we pray. Amen. 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 Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Chumbe.
God bless you all. God bless your partners.
Thank you so much for John Coltrane. That just
absolutely
amazing people.
The words were wonderful.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Go back and listen to that on your own. If you didn't, if you looked at the words this time especially, which are great. But then go back and listen to it. And I mean, just like 6-7 minutes. Do it now. Go on YouTube.
Do
it now. And just listen to it again. And I think God may have something to say to you individually.
I like the words. When it said all that goes back to God, I thought about when you told us that everything belongs to God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Amen.
Everything and everyone. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day.
Everybody have a blessed day.
See you tomorrow morning. Blessings to you.
God bless you.
God bless you, Mariamu.